guys. Everybody doing for a Monday? Anybody coming on that's getting off lockdown or getting out yet? Not quite here where I'm at. So anyway, for those that don't know me, I'm Tracy Gorick. I'm a healing coach, energy healer, spiritual mentor. I use all of that to go in, find out what's wrong, what's caused the illness, clear it out, and then help it heal, and then we work on the spiritual mindset part to have you go back and see why you were where you're at. And if you don't work on that, then the illness will come back in a different way or the same way. So it's very important to work on the mental causes of all this illness, and that's what I wanted to talk to you about today. So when you take away what has hurt you, what do you have? So if you take it away, so you think you have the anger. Why do you have the anger? It's things that have been done to you early on in your life, or even yesterday, right? When you take that away, what do you have? You have your whole self well, healed, not angry, living in peace beautifully, seeing the things that are beautiful in your life. So things that have been done to you have been very damaging, and it's like that for everybody. But that's where we need to take a look at and heal and release it, because otherwise you're causing yourself harm, you're making yourself sick, and you can repeat the patterns with your family or your kids. And you really want to try to avoid that so they have less to work through as they get older. So that's just a very important thing. So pay attention. Like, I'm getting ready to start this group healing program this week, and I'm so excited because we're really going to delve into why are we where we're at? Why do we have these situations going on? You know, why do we have the illness in our body? We need to look at what's going on the mental side of it to really truly heal ourselves whole, body, mind, and spirit. We need to look at all of it to get the body well. So that's one thing I want to give you guys, something to do is like look at when you get rid of the hurt. So you need to look for what has hurt you. When you get rid of it, what do you have? There's nothing there that would be causing you the pain and illness. So you really want to delve into the things that have hurt you in your past and release them and release the people. Because you cannot control what they did to you, and you cannot control that they're going to feel bad, feel sorry, whatever. You can't control any of that. So you need to control yourself and learn to release that stuff. Because otherwise, if you have pain and illness, I can almost guarantee you there's going to be a reason for it. And I've said this before, there's one client, only one that I've had over all the years, 10 years. One client where actually his illness was because his energy was weakened from a fall. Everybody else has been a mental cause for their illnesses that we've had to work on to help them heal. So it's really important to start looking at the things that have caused us to get to where we're at and why we have the anger, upset, frustration. It's really, really important if you want to be able to heal yourself and stay well. So that's what I have for today. So let's go ahead and do the healing real quick, and then we'll close it out. So sit back. If you want the healing, it'll come to you. If you don't worry. It won't be forced on you. You just have to sit back and be open to it. So I want you to imagine the violet flame at your feet coming up and around and through your whole body. It's cleansing, clearing, and purifying everything. Any negative thoughts that come up, I want you to throw that in the violet flame. And this is a step towards releasing the things that have gotten to you to where you're at with the anger, frustration, or hurt that's been caused to you. You just want to put it in the violet flame. And then any negativity you feel that's come at you from other people, anybody getting angry, anybody saying negative things to you, anybody getting upset at you, just put that in the violet flame. Anything that you feel has harmed you from other people, just put that in the violet flame. You have the power to not let it affect you. And then any consciousness around you that you feel that you've picked up on from others, the fear, the anxiety that's out there from people who just don't know what's going on. They're concerned about the COVID, they're concerned about the government, they're just all of that. There's causing a lot of fear and anxiety. You just want to put that in the violet flame. And then when you feel that it's done, take that violet flame and send it back up to source to transmute it. And we'll go ahead and begin the healing now. Okay, that's it for the healing today. Interesting thing lately, I want you to know that a participating energy a lot of times is going in through the heart now, and it's wanting us to open our hearts, and because that's how we can live a more happy, fulfilled life, is opening our hearts. And a lot of people have trouble with that because of being hurt in the past. So that's something you all should just work on, is opening your heart, and things will start to change in your life. And to help you do that, I want you to go imagine your most perfect day, how you want it to be when you come out the other side. I want you to journal it, write it, feel it, sense it, and draw it to you, because that's what we're doing now. That's where the earth's going, okay? You want to, if you can think it, you can have it, and you want to do that. And that's going to help the earth evolve and to help the people around you evolve. Is when you imagine this most perfect day and you dream it, sense it, feel it, it's going to draw it to you, okay? So do that for me. Then go do something you love, something that brings you joy, something that lifts you up. Do at least one thing. Sing, dance, whatever. Watch a movie. And then do some self-care. Drink some tea, meditate, pray, Epsom salt bath. Just do another thing of self-care. So at least two, one of each, but more would be great. Then say something kind to somebody else. Look for the good things in people and say it to them as much as you can, but at least do it once a day, right? And then write 10 things you're grateful for. Do that every day. And I promise you, your life's going to change with just those few things. So start doing them today and change your life. Start healing. Start seeing the good. Don't sit in the bad. Start seeing the good. Okay, guys? So that's what I have for today. I want you guys to have a great day. I have the healing program starts this Thursday. I am doing a 30-minute one-on-one session with that program, and I'm really excited. So I have 6 people signed up, so I have 4 slots left if you're interested in it. I'm really, really excited. I was journaling on it the other day, and all this information's coming in on what we're going to do and what we need to do to help the people that are in the program. So let me know if you're interested. It's going to be good. It's going to be really good. You get 4 weeks working with me, which is a lot more than you get on a one-on-one session, and it's the price of a one-on-one session. So, okay, that's what I have. You guys go have a great day. If you know anybody that this can help, that with the healing to help them reduce their stress and anxiety, please share this out. And that's it. Let me know if you have any questions. I love you all, and I will see you tomorrow.